Jim Harbaugh spoke out on the state of Purdue's visitors' locker room on Monday, calling it a hot box that reminded him of his playing days in the 1980s. Now Purdue is firing back at the Michigan football coach, accusing Harbaugh of making a series of after-the-fact comments when, really, team officials had the opportunity to request alternative accommodations. In a lengthy, four-paragraph retort to Harbaugh's passionate plea to the Big Ten for regulation over visiting football locker rooms, Purdue University said Monday it would be willing to participate in a conference-wide discussion to set guidelines. The after-the-fact concerns expressed by Michigan are somewhat surprising, reads a statement released by the school. A member of its football staff conducted a walkthrough of our facilities with our athletic department's staff at Ross Addey Stadium on July 18. Harbaugh complained of a hot, cramped locker room that lacked the proper ventilation for a 100-degree day, the appropriate number of restrooms and even up-to-date medical equipment. "It got so hot in there before the game," he said. Players were offered the chance to go sit in the team's air-conditioned bus. But Purdue said it warned Michigan ahead of time, and even offered up an alternative place to dress. "To help teams prepare in advance, our visiting team Manuel highlights in bold type, there is no air conditioning in the locker room," with accompanying Purdue Athletics staff contact information about how to request preferred temporary accommodations, Purdue's statement reads. "We did not receive any such request." One of Harbaugh's biggest concerns came on the player safety side. He said Purdue's visitors' locker room had a ribbed table for injured players that looked like it was from the 20s, and quarterback Wilton Spate, after he was knocked out of the game with an undisclosed injury, had to be driven away from the stadium just to have an X-ray performed. "Basic X-ray is available within our athletic footprint and more sophisticated capabilities are located two blocks away, similar to the arrangements at many other schools," the statement reads. "Our sports medicine staff members, in fact, have received numerous compliments from their Michigan counterparts regarding the care they received at Purdue. Built in 1924, Ross Addey Stadium is one of the oldest Big Ten football stadiums still standing. Its last all-encompassing renovation came in 2003, with several visual enhancements, including a $5.6 million project over the summer that added lights, ever since. Harbaugh will join the 13 other Big Ten football coaches on the league's weekly coaches teleconference Tuesday morning. "Should be a doozy."